when we have entered into 75th year of our independence, which we are celebrating the year-long celebrations known as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, Platinum Jubilee of our independence. Our defense forces are one of the finest in the world, and they have won the fear and respect of opponents and the confidence and admiration of our own people. The Indian soldiers have demonstrated qualities of great leadership, discipline, adventure, initiative, endurance, love for those whom they command, and intelligence in tactics. Years ago, while inaugurating the Indian Military Academy, Field Marshal Sir Philip Chotwood said of the Indian troops, "No better material exists in the world, and they have proved it on many sticking fields." This view is endorsed by many knowledgeable people. Under proper leadership, our men in uniform, they display tremendous sense of devotion to the country and sense of sacrifice, where they leave nothing to chance while repelling any aggressor. Now, as India, since our father of nation is Mahatma Gandhi, therefore sometimes doubts are raised whether it is okay for India to build these armed forces in the manner in which we have built them. Ahimsa, of course, non-violence, is an article of faith with us. There is no doubt about it. But ahimsa does not mean timidity. Ahimsa does not mean lack of courage. Ahimsa does not mean that we allow the aggressor to overtake us. Ahimsa means renunciation of hatred. We have no feeling of hatred even for those who have designs on us. Our forces are there to defend our territorial integrity. We have no designs on the others. And the Indian tradition says, it's very clear, Mahatma Gandhi's ahimsa is also inspired by that tradition. It says, agarta chaturo veda, prashta sasharam dhanu, idam brahmam, idam chhatram, shastradapi shastradapi. We should be well equipped with all knowledge which gives you soft power. But at the same time, we must also have the power of weapons. First, in the first instance, we must use soft power, that is power of argument, power of reasoning, power of logic. But ultimately, if it fails, then we will have to take recourse to armed action to defend our integrity. I'm so happy to be here. Particularly, I'm meeting these brave women who are sitting here, and the Bujur on that side,
yes,
sir, my compliments to all of you, and brother, this I'm saying with all sincerity that it is because you are awake at our border that we peacefully sleep in our rooms. We owe so much to you. This is merely a token. This is merely an acknowledgement. This is no reward for your services, for the sacrifices which you have made, your families have made. We remain in debt to you. We have nothing but gratitude for you. So I give you once again, I give you my compliments, my pranams, and I would like to compliment Brigadier Seshadri for organizing this beautiful event. Thank you very much. Nanne Valli, Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu, Jai Hind.
We all know that our Honorable Governor is a fountainhead of knowledge. Sir, your disarming humility and distilled wisdom continues to inspire the multitude and epitomizes the emulative personality of yours, sir.